disk schedulers. So there's four, right? None, MQ deadline, Kyber, and BFQ. So none is the one that's applied to virtual machines and cloud instances. And Nate, you actually very confidently stated why this was
right
in the critical path. Why don't you go ahead and restate that for our viewers?
Right.
Why is none chosen for virtual?
Yeah. So, I mean, there's probably exceptions to this, like in cases where you're mapping physical disks directly into VMs. But if you're using a virtual disk, right, within your virtual environment, then you're going to have another layer of disk performance at the physical layer, right? So the hypervisor that you're running on, or in this case, the cloud hypervisor that our lab environment runs on top of, right? So that is going to have its own disk queuing and whatnot in place. And then your virtual disk inside of that is, well, I mean, the data written to that disk is, or to that virtual disk is going to be beholden to that, you know, it's going to inherit, I don't want to say inherit, the host operating system is going to handle it in its own way.
Yeah. And so generally the reason that you're changing your disk scheduler is because you want to have certain disk operations occur sooner or later. And so you organize the queue where these things are occurring in the queue so that you can push some things out sooner than other things. But in the case of a virtual machine, you do all this work of organizing all of your things, and then you send it to another device that has its own queuing subsystem, and it just reorders it all, right? Based off of not just your machine, but maybe other machines that are running on that hypervisor. And so that's why we choose none, because why should we spend all of our compute time and effort to try and organize this stuff to then just have it redone before it actually gets written to the disk devices on the machine? So that's why none is the one chosen for virtual machines by default. But there's reasons why you might want to not always choose that. So, for example, certain workloads, specifically I'm thinking databases. For databases, if we are trying to retrieve a piece of data, that read request to go out and retrieve the piece of data, somebody's waiting on, right? The database is waiting on it to retrieve, but then there's some other application that queried the database that's also waiting for that thing to be retrieved. And so oftentimes for database workloads, we want to prioritize reads from the IO subsystem because we know that somebody is waiting on it and we want to minimize that wait time. The flip side is if we're prioritizing reads, then what happens to the write requests where we're actually trying to save data? And so those end up being cached for longer periods, but we don't want to cache them forever because if we were to lose power or something else happens on the machine, we'd lose that data if it was never written out to the disk. And so that's where the deadline scheduler is handy. We see deadline scheduler used a lot as an alternative when we have those workloads that have applications waiting on data to be retrieved from the disk. The other one is BFQ, which is fair queuing. Fair queuing used to be the default, like back in the day for RHEL. But now we either default to MQ deadline or none. BFQ is there for kind of like desktop-y things where you want a balance between reads and writes. With deadline, we're biasing the system to choose reads and we're caching those writes longer, which means we're using up memory for storing the writes. And there's some danger of like, if something happens to the system, we would lose that data. And so for something like a laptop, where you could be on battery and you could lose power, you probably don't want to buffer up a whole bunch of data that might evaporate if you lose power. And so things like workstations or laptops, they'll often choose fair queuing for their disk IO so that they can kind of do a balance between reads and writes and kind of keep everybody happy with the data. The flip side is if you have an application waiting on a disk piece of disk data to be retrieved, it will wait, right? Because there might be some writes that are queued up in front of it and they have to wait. And so there's a big mechanism in BFQ on how you establish fairness between the reads and the writes. We're not going to get into that today. Just know that it's fair and there's not bias towards one type of disk operation.
But how do the reads feel versus the writes? I mean, like, do they feel as though they're being treated fairly? Because that's also important.
I mean, they should be feel that way, unlike deadline, where they clearly are preferred and get to jump to the front of the line all the time. The other one that we pointed out was Kyber. Kyber is a weird one. It doesn't have much in the way of tunables. What its job is to maintain a consistent latency or speed of disk I/O. So if they're not doing writes quickly enough to meet the criteria for how quickly they should be done, the Kyber system will actually queue disk reads and writes, disk operations longer, and slow down disk I/O operations that are being sent to the devices to try and maintain this speed and throughput that's happening on the disk devices. So Kyber is kind of, it was introduced maybe 5-ish, maybe 10 years ago as an experiment. I don't know a lot of workloads that are specifically benefited by Kyber in the same way that we'll see things like MQ deadline benefit workloads. All right. So that's a little bit on what the different schedulers are. Now, when should you use them? So really, you should choose between three of them for sure. None, MQ deadline, and BFQ. None, I'm a virtual machine, and I don't want to waste my compute time doing a bunch of organization that's just going to be redone by somebody right. else. I have applications that will occasionally need to read from the disk, and I want those reads to be preferentially treated so I get those responses quickly, minimizing the wait time of my users that are waiting for that data. If you have a web application that is either database-backed or file-backed, you might want to use deadline as your scheduler for that application. And you may even want to use it in a virtual machine environment just so that you're sending the reads to the hypervisor first before the writes and you're queuing up writes. And then the third one is BFQ, fair queuing. That's for things like workstations or computers that you sit at and work at as a human. We really don't use those for operational workloads.